guys, how are you all doing? If you're new here, welcome. My name is Krazy Ken, and last week Microsoft officially revealed Windows 11. And today, people in the Insider program got a developer build of the operating system, so I wanted to show you what's new real quick. So, let's take a look. I want to address a few questions I know everybody has. First, when is Windows 11 coming out to the public? So an official date hasn't been announced yet by Microsoft, but it will likely be in the US's fall season, possibly on October 20th. How much will Windows 11 cost? Windows 11 will be a free upgrade for any eligible user, for example, a Windows 10 user. And finally, is my computer compatible with Windows 11? So I have a link in the description for Microsoft's PC Health Check program. Go ahead and run that program and it will tell you if your PC is compatible. The two important things to note are Windows 11 will only run on 64-bit hardware and you need secure boot enabled and TPM 2.0. All right, let's dive into the new stuff. My favorite big change is the all new design. It's refreshing, yet familiar. A center-aligned taskbar, a redesigned tile-less start menu, rounded window corners, and even an all-new out-of-box experience with new graphics and animations. And a new startup sound. Oh yeah, that's nice. Icons in the taskbar playfully shift when new icons pop up, and certain icons are animated when you click on them too. And if you'd like, you can still left-align the icons. The Settings app has been completely redesigned. Yes, it's even different compared to the leak Windows 11 build we saw earlier. And the category list is always readily available in the sidebar, no matter which settings are open. And there's all new wallpapers and themes bundled with Windows 11 too. And of course, dark mode is still there for you. I also made this new wallpaper inspired by Windows 11, and if you like it, you can download it with the link in the description. Now, many people have been wanting a File Explorer overhaul, and it looks like the ribbon has been removed and a new toolbar with some new icons has replaced it, but it doesn't appear to be a major overhaul in the design. Will we get some more changes in future dev builds? Maybe, but let's not hold our breath. Up next, the Maximize button now offers snap layout, so you can easily rearrange your windows with a click. And Windows 11 will even remember what your snap layout was on an external monitor. Windows 11 also has a new dashboard feature which contains widgets such as weather and calendar for easy at-a-glance information. Is anyone else getting some serious Windows Vista nostalgia with this? Oh yeah, the gadget sidebar, remember that? Good times. No matter how hard you look, you will not find Skype pre-installed with Windows 11. Some people might be overjoyed by that. But you will find Microsoft Teams. Microsoft Teams is now integrated into the system. Teams can be used by consumers or can be used for commercial use. It works with chats, it works with video calls, and there's even a universal mute button in your system tray so you can mute your microphone from any application. Under the hood, Teams is switching away from Electron, and it will now be a Microsoft Edge WebView 2 application, which can offer benefits such as less RAM usage. Now, before I move on to the next thing quick, I just wanted to mention I released an episode on my other show, Krazy Ken's Tech Misadventures, about the Windows 11 leaked build, where I install it and test drive it for the first time. It's all raw and unscripted, and it was a lot of fun, so feel free to check that out. All right, what's next? There's some big changes coming to the Microsoft Store. The new store will host more applications regardless of app framework, including traditional and familiar Win32 applications. For example, Adobe Creative Cloud will now be in the Microsoft Store. Another important feature is if a developer has their own commerce system they want to integrate, they can still host their app in the store without having to go through Microsoft's commerce system. And guess what? They keep 100% of the revenue, so that's a pretty big thing there. But wait, there's more. Android apps will also be available in the Microsoft Store via the Amazon App Store integration. Windows 11 uses Intel Bridge technology to run the Android apps, and according to Microsoft, Android app compatibility will also work on AMD and ARM devices running Windows 11. So lots of cool features coming with Windows 11, and I'm sure there will be more updates with these future developer builds before the official release, so feel free to follow me on Twitter, and I will let you know about that stuff as soon as I get that information. And feel free to let me know what you think about Windows 11 in the comments below. And feel free to subscribe for more tech episodes all the time. I release them as much as I can. I like doing episodes about rare and retro tech, new tech, and of course, scam tech. So feel free to follow along. It's a fun time. And hey, if you like this episode, you know what to do. Thanks for sticking with me. Catch the Krazy and pass it on.